साथ चलिए बड़े लोग वट एवर एंड वी वॉन्ट टू डू मैरिज टॉक फॉर अवर गर्ल अवर डॉटर. सो शी वेंट एंड सैट इन अ हाउस इन चारखोप एंड शी वेन शी एंटर्ड शी सिटिंग देयर चाय वाय चल रहा है एंड शी गॉट शी वॉज रेस्टलेस. She kept looking around and after 10-15 minutes people are talking, she realized somebody is watching me. And she realized this is the same gali that I came to 4 months back to show Anand Patwardhan to shoot in this gali because a Muslim woman was gang raped in this gali by the neighbors that she lived with for 20 years before that. She went through the gali, she knocked on the door, she howled for help. And no one opened the doors. So Shaila Satpute got really, then when she realized, shit, this was the same gali, she kept asking, she said, ye gali ka naam kya hai? So they said, the gali. And she said, dada, nikalte hain, hume jana hai. To utke beech mein hi chai vai ho gaya tha, hum aapko baad mein batayenge, nikal aaye. Then she said, hume nahi deni apni beti wahan. So they didn't, because she was looking so distraught, they didn't ask at that time. When she later asked, she just said, that was the same gali in which you remember I had told you about this woman that I had taken, she had come to my mother too. All of these are activists that work together. Her husband was killed, she was gang raped, and no one helped her in the gali. So this woman who has gone to do marriage talk, the first thought is, if you don't know, there are 3 boys in this family. One is the prospective bridegroom. There are other 2. Where were these boys when this gang rape was happening? Were they amongst the rapists? Is one of them a rapist? If they were not there, what were they doing? Were they around watching? What were the women of this family doing? When the woman was howling, they did not go out and say, bas kariye. They did not do anything. How do you give your own daughters into these kind of families, which are anyways patriarchal, where our daughters are supposed to serve them and all of that? And what do you expect? How will they be treated in a home of rapists? So she said, the problem is not about them that you kill or you rape. The problem is with us, because you have vitiated our society so much. What will you do with this kind of a... not just blame and guilt, but also a change in attitude, change in culture, change in the value system with which now the next generations must live. If you go to this, I've made a speech in, I will always say to young people, if you go to, I used to work with a center called Dilasa in Bombay that started in Bhabha Hospital, that was to help women with legal advice, but women who have ended up in hospital. So most of the women who you meet in the hospital, who are hospitalized, are to be found in the burns department. If you go to the burns department, you see women up to 90% burned. How does this happen? You have several women in that burns department. You hardly find a man. These are women who are burned by their whole own families. Their intimate partners, men who actually are sleeping with these people. So the same body, they go and burn up to 90%. This is the kind of thing that happens anyways in our society to women. Once you create this kind of a discourse and change of value system where killing of a person is pleading person, is dying person, is whatever, you won't give water, you will give them rockel if they ask for water. All of this will happen. Happens to you, what happens to your soul? What happens then to the next generations or the women and children in your households? So a book like this or a project like this for memory is for the majority and the weaker sections of that majority. Why should we do it now? Now is actually a good time, but I was hoping Hossein is going to anyways possibly speak of why to look at this kind of a thing now. But if you just look at this, someone sent me a joke. I wish it was a joke. It's now in India, breakfast, lunch, tea, dinner. Next day, breakfast, lunch, tea, dinner. Since that is the situation, something like this, to say that this has happened, and we should not cater to the same kind of thing. If we begin this way, if we start with Rath Yatra, before that, if we start with accepting that Sikhs can be killed in Delhi with impunity, then we accept Muslims can be killed in Bombay with impunity, then they can be killed again in 2002 in Gujarat. That can happen. No community can be killed with this kind of cruelty and impunity. Once we accept that in one city of the country, then we accept it somewhere else with some other community. It's all minorities, it's all vulnerable. So it is important to note that. And in Rekha Thakur's thing in this, she says that the main part was not the killings of Muslims. It was there, demonization of Muslims. To kill them, you have to demonize them. How badly they treat their women. I'm teaching family law. Forever my students think, tipal talaq, char biviya, paanch kya, 25 bachche, whatever. All of this you actually teach and you make your population believe. Then it's easy to kill a person because it's no more a human. It's a cockroach, you can kill. They, in Rwanda, called people while killing, they called them cockroaches. In radio, they kept saying cockroaches. So if you make people, humans, something else, then it's easy to kill cockroaches. So that is one thing. But Rekha Thakur, because she's an activist, but she's with Bahujan Samaj Party, she thought that it's not just demonization of the Muslim, but also the criminalization of the Bahujan. Who does the killing? Who do you use to do the killing on the street? So the Nagpur branch of RSS, the Maharashtrian Brahmin, does not actually go to kill. Though they're training very hard now to learn to kill. They want to become Muslims and learn to kill and that kind of thing. But it's the Bahujan who knows to yield the chura, the whatever, the kuradi. So it's easy then to have this double agenda work, that you kill and you create killers. And the creation of the killers then also will kill the possibility of revolution that has started long time back and has been then had seen a lot of ruptures. So Maharashtra, Bombay is the place where workers movement was at the zenith. Ambedkar did a lot of his politics there. Gandhi did a lot of his politics there. Phule did his politics in Pune. So Sant Parampara happens there. So there is a lot there that is progressive politics. And to fight that, this is a very good tool. Otherwise, how do you fight progressive politics? You must create a wedge between us and them. And then you create the us. And within the us, then can you actually create the Bahujans which are doing your beckoning. So this is also expressed in this. The last one that I would like to mention is Sudhanva Deshpande, one of my favorites in the book. The language is lucid and the expression is beautiful also. And he says how he came to terms with the 8 worst years of the Republic. It started in 84 when he was a schoolboy in growing up in JNU, the bubble of JNU where his father taught. And father once said, go bring newspaper. And when he went to the kiosk, he could not find the newspaper. So he went cycling through Delhi and finding more and more stuff that was fascinating and gruesome. And he saw a Sikh gentleman being descended upon by a mob of hounds men. And he was bleeding and he was trying to run. And Sudhanva saw all this in 84 when he was a boy. Then he says how that began my consciousness. Then I went to college, I joined Safdar Hashmi. I fell in love with Safdar Hashmi, he was my mentor, then he was killed. Then there came Bhopal gas tragedy, where you saw how capitalist government, how capitalist our socialist government has become, who takes the Union Carbide people, puts them on the plane and sends them off to America so that there should be no problems for their lives. While they say 400 people who are fighting say 4,000, but thousands of people died breathing that poisonous gas. And last comes then happened Roop Kanwar, where all of these people gathered together and rejoiced a burning, a cerebrational religious burning of a young widow. And the last one was 92, where it did not happen that easily. 90s when it started, the Rath Yatra went through varied states and then it landed us in this kind of a position where a masjid that was sitting there was destroyed and the country shook. I wanted to read the one page of the introduction, and that's where I'm going to end and hand over to Osi. A story. Once upon a time, there was a masjid. Or was it a mandir that became a masjid? Or was it the other way around? No one can be sure. But on 6 December 1992, what was destroyed was definitely a masjid. This was how it was for the entirety of 500 years. It was standing there, through heat and dust, fog and cold, minding its own business. It was destroyed by a mob of monkeys. They must be blessed by Lord Ram. On that Sunday, they jumped on the old structure, hacked at it, while the army looked on and the police chewed on pan. Then the Muslims came out in protest. The Hindutva mobs came out to teach them a lesson. Police came out to shoot the Muslims, and others did not come out. Gandhiji. Remember, Gandhiji said in 1948, the killers are roaming on the streets freely because the peace-loving people are hiding behind closed doors. If they came out and said, "Not in my name," they would be able to stop the violence. Now we have placed Gandhi on our currency notes, where he purchases vegetables and mobile covers for us. Who will tell us to show courage and stop violence in the name of communalism? Thank you so much.
Not use it, I guess. So, Samina, you know, I was there in India and during 1992, December 6th, and I clearly remember the day. Some students, some fellow students, Hindus, came and told me that the mosque had collapsed, and I couldn't believe it. Because it had been going on for so long that the fact that it had broken that it would break was not conceivable. We thought that this movement will continue and, you know, elections will be won on this basis. So it seemed like an incredible day. But India changed. India changed during that movement. We saw people saying things which would not have been acceptable earlier in the public realm. I remember after it broke, things became even worse.